Yes, good afternoon to one and all. Now, welcome to the today's session. There are some instructions to the students. Now, we observed in the last class. All of you listen carefully. Now, the first thing is, some of the students, they are not attending the lecture classes, but still they are attempting the quiz part. Now the faculty, they are collecting the information before starting the quiz and after submitting the quiz. But some of the students, they are not listening to the classes. Now from the management, now what we got the instructions is, those who listen the class and who are attempting the quiz, those only will get the awarded with the marks. And these will be considered for the assignment marks for the coming sessions, for the mid exams. And one more thing is, last class we caught some of the students. Now only one student is submitting the different students, that means with the different roll numbers. Now here IP addresses we are observing. Now with the same IP address, any two persons, they are submitting the answers, ultimately those two persons, they are going to be punished. It is very serious instruction to everyone, because the intention of conducting the quiz is, it should be transparent. Okay, if after completion of the class, how extent you people understand, that will be, we can understand with the help of the quiz. Now, last class, we already posted some of the roll numbers in this chat box. Now, that is the last warning we gave to every students. Now, from today's class onwards, if we observe any same IP addresses with more number of roll numbers, those people can be kept under the blacklist. Okay, keep these two things in your mind, and we'll move on to the today's topic. So today we are going to start the new topic, that is one more applications of your diode, that is the clipper circuits. Right. Then the last class we discussed one of the applications of your diodes, that is a rectifier applications. Now in the today's class, the one more application of diode, that is a clippers. Clipper, the name itself, it is saying it is clipping some portion of the signal, and we are not obtaining the complete signal at the output side. Now this is having some lot of the advantages in the practical cases. Now today we will discuss about this clippers concept. It is looking like, excuse me. Yeah. Now, if you follow these slides, then you will get the clarity. And today's slides, maximum theory part I avoided. Only the pictures are there. And I will explain you with the help of the circuit diagrams. Now you try to write in your own way, because in the examinations, it will be very, very useful. Only the circuit part is there. Now for that circuit, what is the input and what the output we will obtain? That we are going to see in the today's class. Now, what is a clipper circuit? The clipper circuit, what is a rectifier in the last class we have seen? The rectifier is a circuit that will convert the analog signal, that means AC signal, to your pulsating DC signal. Now, clipper is also one circuit, now which is also known as the limiter. Other name of your clippers is limiters, amplitude selector, or the slicers. These are the three other names of your clipper circuits. Clippers are used to eliminate the portion of a signal that are above or below the specified level, that is a clip valve. Now, if I want to remove a specific portion of the signal that is above the reference level or below the reference level, now I am going to use the clipper circuit. Now, best example of your clipper circuit is your half-wave rectifier. What is a half-wave rectifier? Now, it is clipping the negative part of your signal, because in the half-wave rectifier, now what we are seeing, output of half-wave rectifier, now output of half-wave rectifier is Now this is a signal you are output of the half wave rectifier. Only positive peak you are going to see. It is clipping the negative peak. And once again, you are getting only positive peak. Now that is the best example of your clipper. Now what is a clipper? It will clip a certain amount of the portion of your signal. Now clipper circuits are used to eliminate the portion of your signal. That means the here complete negative peak I am able to remove here. Or if I want to remove only some portion of the signal also, you can clip with the help of these clipper circuits. That we are going to discuss in the coming slides. Now, once again, the clipper circuits, other name of clipper circuits are limiters, amplitude selectors, or slicers, are used to eliminate the portion of the signal that are above or below the specified level. That specified level we are calling as a reference level, or other name of that is a clip value. What is a clip value? Above that value or below that value, now we are removing the portion of the signal. Now the purpose of the diode is that when it is turned on, it provides the clip value. Now we are making the diode to turn on to clip the certain amount of the certain portion of your given signal. A clipper which removes a portion of the positive half of the signal, that is called as a positive clipper. Now here the different types of clippers are there. Don't confuse at the end of the class. Now first type of classification of clippers is positive clipper and second one is negative clipper. What is a positive clipper? A clipper which removes a portion of positive half cycle. Now a circuit which removes the positive path, that is you're calling as a positive clipper. Now second one is a clipper which removes a portion of the negative half of the cycle, that is called a negative clipper. That is in the negative clippers, it is removing all the negative portions of the signal. I hope it is clear. Now what is circuit diagrams of positive clippers and negative clipper? The best example is if you connect the diode in the reverse bias case, in this case, now what is going to happen? This, if you are applying a signal positive peak, now this is going to be reverse bias, it is going to be in off. Now during the negative cycle, then diode is conducting, that is a forward bias, the negative peak is going to follow the input signal. Now that's why if the diode is connecting in this fashion, this circuit you are calling as a positive clipper. The diode is connecting in this fashion, this circuit you are calling as your negative clipper. Keep the diode in your mind. The orientation of diode will clip the portion of your signal. Okay, always remember, for the diode, this is your positive and this is your negative side. This is your cathode and this is your anode side. Now if you are applying the signal, first positive peak will come and then followed by negative peak, positive peak and negative peak. According to this, now we are going to obtain the specified waveforms. Now in this slide I am telling only two types of clippers are there. One is a positive clipper which removes the positive portion of the signal, that is a positive clipper. Circuit diagram for positive clipper is, now put the diode in the reverse bias case here. The cathode is connected to the input terminals, anode is connected to the output terminals, that is the positive clipper side. Now what is a negative clipper? It is negative clipper is nothing but your half wave rectifier. Okay, what is the orientation of this? Now this cathode must be to the output side, anode must be to the input signal side. Now the clipper which removes the negative portion of the signal, that is your negative clipper. Right. Now there is one more classification is there in the clipper circuits. That depending upon the position of the diode, that means where you are putting the diode, the clippers are classified into series clippers and shunt clippers. What is series clipper? If the diode is connected in series with the load, the circuits we are calling as a series clipper circuit. Now what we see in the previous slide, half wave rectifier, I said about the positive and negative clippers now. Those comes under even this type of things. See here. Now we can see, we cannot say that is a thing, but this is, if you are having only this configuration, this is a series clipper. But generally this comes under even, if diode connecting at this point, that it comes under even parallel place. Now if the diode in series with the load, if you are connecting these two in series, that clipper circuits we are calling as a series clipper circuit. So what is a parallel clipper circuit? Now the resistance and the diode must be connected across your output terminals. Now the resistor and the diode, if the across the output terminal, if you are connecting the diode, now this type of circuits we are calling as parallel clipper circuits. Now observe the difference between these two. Series clippers is diode is connected in series with your resistance. Now what is a parallel clipper circuit? Diode is that is in parallel to the, what is generally what we are having, output side the RL we are connecting. Now these two will be in parallel. across the load only we are going to collect the output. Okay, I hope it is clear. This slide is clear to everyone. Now, what is the series clipper? Diode is connected in series with the resistance is the series clipper. Here, where you are collecting output? Output you are collecting across the load. This output you are collecting across the load. What is a parallel clipper circuit? If output you are collecting across the diode, that circuit you are calling as your parallel clipper circuit. Right, we will discuss these circuits and how these circuits are clipping the portion of the signal that we will discuss in the coming slides. First, we will take the parallel clipper circuit. Okay, now first we will discuss about the parallel clipper circuits. Then we will discuss about the serial clipper circuits. Now with this, today we will wind up the clippers part. Now this is the input signal. Now once again, with the help of my drawings, I will explain what are the picture you are able to see. That is a direct picture I kept in the PPT. But you, in order to explain this, I need to draw once again the circuit diagrams. It is very difficult to draw very neatly or smoothly. Now try to understand the way of in what way I am drawing the circuits with respect to my voice. And now this is the input signal. My input signal is that it has the maximum voltage of Vm, and it is a periodic signal. Now it is from 0 to t. It is continuously varying with respect to the 0 to t. The half cycle of T by 2, right? Now, if you apply now this to your parallel circuit, this is a parallel clipper circuit. Parallel clipper circuit is, what is a parallel clipper circuit? Output you are collecting across your diode. Now, see here, I want to tell, before starting this, I want to tell you one thing to you. Now, normally, when the diode will be in forward bias? The diode will be in forward bias. This is the anode and this is the cathode side. This is P, this P side is you are connecting to your, what is forward bias? This is a positive you are connecting. Here you are connecting the negative, that is in forward bias case. This is a P and this is your N type. Now if you are connecting the positive to the P type material, negative to the N type material, that is in forward bias. Now, just I am adding some little bit extension to this. Always don't keep this concept in your mind. Now see what is going to happen. Now, for example, here I am applying the plus 5 volts at this point. Here I am applying the plus 2 volts at this point. But remember, see, follow the things. The two sides I am applying the positive voltage only. Now, what is the status of this diode? This diode will be in forward bias or reverse bias? It is in forward bias. See how it is. Now, see the potential difference between the two terminals. Now, it is more positive compared to this one. Now, plus 5, this P side is, it is a more positive compared to the N side. This is a plus 2 volts. Now, that's why I am going to consider this side only, I am going to consider. Now, this more positive is giving to the P side. Now, negative is giving to the lower positive. Actually, it is not the negative value. It is compared to this value, higher value, this is a very lower value. Now, that's why diode will be in forward bias. Now, I will go for the another case. What is the reverse bias case? Now in the reverse bias, normally you are connecting negative at this point. You are connecting the positive at this terminal. That is a reverse bias, normal reverse bias scenario. Now, if I am applying minus 6 volts at this point, if I am applying at the minus 2 volts at this point, now what is the status of this diode? The status of the diode will be in reverse bias. See about these two. Now this, with respect to this terminal, you are applying the more reverse voltage. Now compared to this negative voltage, this smaller reverse voltage is there. Now with respect to the voltage difference, see the two terminals. Now which is having the more voltage? That is minus 6 is more voltage. Now it is connected to the P-type. That's why it is going to be in reverse bias. I hope you people are having some little bit confusion. Once again, I will clarify the same thing here. Right. Now see, remember, because for our clipper circuits, this is a heart. If you are not able to understand this part, ultimately this today's topic, you cannot understand. Now, normal forward bias is, what is a normal forward bias case? Now we'll take the two scenarios parallelly. For the normal forward bias case, this positive must be connected to your, this P side, negative must be connected to your N side, that is nothing but diode will be in forward bias. Is it clear? Now, what is a reverse bias case? If you are connecting the negative supply, negative terminal to the P side, and if you are connecting the positive terminal to the N side, now this is in your reverse bias case. This is what we studied till now. Now, I am adding a small thing to this concept. Now, the diode will be in forward bias and the diode will be in reverse bias, even though they are not having the opposite polarities. That means one side positive, another side negative. One side negative, one side positive is the normal case. But even though two side, if you are having the positive voltages also, the diode will be in forward bias. And the two sides you are having in the negative voltage also, diode will be in reverse bias. Now, how you can make it is in forward bias? Now, if you are applying the more positive voltage, I am taking the plus 6 volts at this side. Now, with respect to the plus 1 volt, I am applying at this side. Now, see, at the N side, you are applying the smaller positive potential, but at the SP side, you are applying the more and more potential. In this case also, diode will be in forward bias. Just to remember this point. Now, what is that? Now, see the two ends of your diode. Now, which side is having the more voltage? Now, take that portion only. Now, what is the other side? If you are having the two positive voltages are there, is a plus 1 volt is there, now plus 6 volt is there. Now, always take this plus 6 volts as a reference. Now, plus is more voltage you connect into the P side, this is in forward bias. Coming to the same reverse bias, here minus 6 volts is there, and the minus 2 volts is there. Out of these two, minus 6 is very, very high. Now, in this case, second case, you are not going to think about the second case, second side. Now, if it is a more higher negative voltage is there, higher negative voltage, you are connecting to the P side. That's why it is in reverse bias. Now, you can leave about the second terminal side. Okay, this is a small difference you are going to observe. Now, from now onwards, I will compare the two sides of your diode. Now, this side, how much voltage I am getting? This side, how much voltage I am getting? Whether it is plus and minus, directly you can say diode is in forward reverse bias. So both will be plus or both will be minus, negative you are getting. Now, which is having the higher value? Now, higher value is giving to which type of terminal? Based on that, I can decide. Now, diode will be in forward bias or reverse bias. I hope it is clear to everyone. Right? Now, we move on to our actual topic. Now, so that you will get the clarity. Right, now you take this is the input signal you are applying, the Vin first initially during the positive. Now see, this diagram's output I have taken for this, I am considering this is ideal diode. What is an ideal diode? The diode will conduct for 0 volts is also ideal diode. But what is a practical diode? When the PN junction diode will conduct greater than barrier potential, that is a 0.7 volts. Keep this in your mind. But whatever the diagrams, pictures I am showing, this is for ideal diode only. What is a practical case? Now, practical signal will be like this. Because 0.7 volts is there, it may not get same, shape is going to be same, but the values are not going to be the same. Because at this point, it is starting, but at the 0 volts only, negative 0 only it is starting. But minus 0.7, it is going to start generally. Now, this is a minus 0.7, it will start the follow the thing. And again, it will come, whenever it is less than the minus 0.7, again, the current is going to be 0. Now, whatever the pictures are there in the presentation, now you take that as the ideal diode case. In the ideal diode, I am considering for 0 volts, for a smaller value, some 0.1 volt, that is positive volt. Now, the diode is conducting. That is what I am assuming. But practically, if more than 0.7 volts, then only diode will conduct. But for ideal diode, now you can take, it is greater than 0 also, diode will conduct. Now, for explanation purpose, I am taking the ideal value. But even though in case of your examination also, you can take the same diagrams. But don't forget to mention it is an ideal diode. These circuits are for your ideal diode circuits. For practical diodes, what you have to do? You have to reduce the value, reduce the waveform. That means it is ideally from 0 onwards it is starting. Practically, above the 0.7 only diode will start conducting. That is small difference between these two. Is it clear up to this? Shall I continue? Still, I have not started clippers. Just I gave you only the concept. Shall I continue the class? Yeah. Now, just focus here. Focus only little, 10 minutes you focus here, then all the circuits will be very clear to you people. Right. Now, this is during the positive cycle. Now, what is going to happen? During the positive half, and now the signal is coming to here. Now, this side is becoming your positive, and this side is becoming your negative. That is the signal you are applying generally. Now, the positive is connecting to your N side. The negative is connected to the P side. What is the status of this diode? The diode will be in reverse bias. In the reverse bias, diode will be as an open circuit. There is no current flowing through the diode. Is it clear? Now, during the positive half of the cycle, there is no current flowing through the diode. That means here it is going to be open circuit. The complete maximum, whatever the input signal is there, that is flowing through the load only. Just imagine output side load is connected, RL. Now, what is, because these two will be in parallel, whatever the voltage across the load, the same thing is across your diode also. But it is an open circuit. Now, I removed the, that means this is in reverse bias. Remember, in the reverse bias, diode is open circuit. In the forward bias, diode is short circuited. In the forward bias, I will consider my diode as your short circuit. The reverse bias, I will consider it is your open circuit. Now, for this positive peak of the input signal, this is going to be reverse bias. It is going to be open circuit. There is no current flowing through this path. The complete signal is flowing through the output side only. Now, that's why output signal is, during the positive half of the signal, the diode is, it is open circuit case, output is following the input signal. Now, during the complete positive cycle. You got it? Because here it is open circuit. Nothing is flowing through this. Everything is flowing through the Vout, output terminal. Ideally, generally, a small load resistor is connected. The output voltage is nothing but across the load. Across the load, what is it? It is an open circuit now. This portion is removed. Now, the complete signal is flowing through this part only, output side. Now, that's why, now during the positive half of the signal, now output is following your input signal. Yes. Now, come to the negative peak of the signal. Now, what is going to happen for negative peak of the signal? Whenever it is coming to the negative value, now this is becoming your negative, and this is becoming your positive, the signal. Whenever the negative is connected to, I went to the second circuit, but even though no problem, I'm explaining second circuit, then we can come for the first circuit also. Yeah. Now, see, in this case, the negative voltage is connected to the negative terminal, and the positive is connected to the positive side. Now, the status of this diode? The diode will be in forward bias. But during the forward bias, now how it will act as your short circuit? Now, ultimately, there is a load across this. I'm considering this is a, RL is a small amount of load resistance is there. There is a short circuit path is there. Ultimately, the current is choosing the low resistance path. That means the complete current is flowing through the short circuit only. What is the output across this? The output across this is nothing but your zero. I think people are aware of this short circuit and open circuit. Now, whenever this is a short circuit, it is having the zero resistance value, but always the current will flows the lower resistance path. Now, compared to RL, it is very, very small. It is always zero, it is short circuit. And so the complete current, the negative peak is completely flowing through this short circuit path. Now, that's why output voltage is equal to zero. Now, that's why T by 2 to T, the output voltage is going to be zero. I hope it is clear. Once again, I will explain here. Now, during the positive half of the cycle, now this is a positive and this is a negative, it is becoming, it is in reverse bias. In the reverse bias case, it is going to be open circuit. Open circuit means the current is not flowing through this path. Now, whatever the signal is, that signal is completely flowing through the output side, load resistance. Now, imagine here my load resistance RL is there. Output I am collecting through the load resistance RL. Now, that's why during the positive peak, the complete signal is, we are getting across the load resistance, that's why output is following the input signal. Now, during the negative half of the cycle, this diode is acting as in forward bias, because the negative is connected to N side, positive is connected to the P side. So that's why it is in forward bias. In the forward bias, it is acting as a short circuit. Whenever there is a short circuit path, this is parallel to the resistance value, the complete current is flowing through the low resistance, that is a short circuit path only. That means this side, the current is equal to zero. There is no current flow through this path. There is no current means, that means second part of your signal is going to be clipped here. Now this is nothing but your, this is a negative clipper. Now in the parallel clipper circuit, you are clipping the negative half of the portion. I hope this is clear. Now this is one type of parallel clipper circuit. Now we will see the one more type of parallel clipper circuit, that is a positive clipper. Now what is the positive clipper? Now you put the direction of, that means same, just I am interchanging the diode polarities. Now here I am taking the negative to positive, you are connecting diode, you reverse the diode, that is nothing but your positive clipper circuit. This is parallel clipper positive side. Under the parallel clipper, it is clipping the positive clip of the circuit. Now see here, now if you connect the diode in this fashion, now tell me the value, which one is going to be clipped. Now during the positive half of the cycle, this is the positive half of the cycle. Now what is going to, this is becoming your positive, this is becoming your negative. Now for a positive to P side, negative to N side, what is the status of this diode? This is in forward bias. In the forward bias, diode will act as your short circuit. Whenever the diode is short circuit, there is no current flowing through the output side. That's why during the positive terminal, the zero current is flowing through the output side. Now coming to the negative side, this is the negative peak of your input signal. Now this terminal is becoming your negative, this is becoming your positive. In this case, negative is connected to the P side and the positive is connected to the N side. Now the diode will be in reverse bias. In the reverse bias, how it is acting as your open circuit. Now whenever this diode is removed, it is open circuit, the complete current is flowing through your load resistance only. Now that's why now the negative peak of signal is, output is following the negative peak of the signal. During the negative half of the signal, it will conduct. That means the output is following the input signal. Now this circuit is clipping the positive peak of the signal, because during the positive side, now it is in forward bias. In the forward bias, the diode is acting as a short circuit. Now whenever it is shorted, the complete current is flowing through the shorted path only. You are not getting any output voltage across it. Okay, now this is the simple a parallel circuits with a positive clipper circuit as well as your negative clipper circuit. This is your negative side is clipping here, that's why it is a negative clipper circuit. Now here positive side is clipping, that's why it is your positive clipper circuit. Now what is the arrangement for positive clipping? The arrangement for positive clipping will be, now keep the diode will be in this fashion, parallelly. For the negative clipping, now what is the position of your diode? Now place the diode will be in this position. This is a simple difference between your positive clipping circuit as well as your negative clipping circuit in parallel circuits. Okay, right. Now we move on to the next one. I don't want to clip the complete portion of the negative or a complete portion of the positive. That means here it is completely clipping the negative. Here it is completely clipping the positive. No, I don't want to clip all those things. Now I want to clip only this portion of negative value. I want to clip only half of your positive portion, only small portion of your positive signal, positive peak. How to design a circuit? Now that is nothing but our third one. Right, now before going this, now how to clip the portion of your signal, that is with biasing voltage, third type. The first one is direct parallel circuit with the positive clipping, parallel circuit with the negative clipping is completed. Now the third type of clippers is same parallel clipper with the biasing voltage. Now what I am doing, I am including a battery in the circuit, that is in series with the diode. Now I am not clipping the complete portion, only some portion of the signal only I am keeping. Now if I want to clip the positive portion of the small positive portion of your input signal, so that you are connecting, it is diode will be in this fashion. If you want to clip only smaller portion of your negative peak or reverse the diode, it will clip only small portion of your negative side. How we will see now, what is the operation of this, how it is clipping only this portion, that I will discuss now. Right, just to focus here, this is very very important one for the next slide. Now I am including a battery in series with your diode, and now this is a V, the voltage of your battery is V. I am assuming this is a 2 volts is there. For a practical purpose I am taking, but it is not 2 volts, it is a V volt it is having. Now this is the input signal, my maximum voltage is nothing but this is the maximum voltage is Vm, and my voltage, the battery, what I am kept in the circuit is nothing but the voltage is V. Now for example, I am assuming my Vm is equal to 5 volts maximum voltage, my reference voltage I am taking as your 2 volts. Now that's why this V is, this dotted line is nothing but my battery reference voltage. Now it is consistently producing the 2 volts. Battery is a DC battery. It is, what is the voltage of this DC battery? 2 volts. That's why this is a reference level of your battery. And what is a AC signal? AC signal is, it has a peak value of Vm. Now it is going to vary up to the, it will go to the plus 5 to the minus 5. It is switching in between plus 5 volts to minus 5. Practical purpose only, I have selected 5 and 5 for the clear understanding purpose. Right. Now, if you apply this signal to this type of circuits, that means the circuit which is having the battery in the circuit. Now, what is going to happen for the input signal? That we are going to discuss. Right. Now, first consider. Now, in the last slide, I explained. Now, this diode is already, it is negative side is connecting to which terminal? Positive terminal. Now, he already 2 volts is there. The plus is connected to your negative side. This generally, it is in which configuration it is? The positive is connected to negative side. This is in reverse bias case. Initially, it is going to be in reverse bias case because with the inclusion of your battery DC source, with the help of the DC source, it itself acting as a reverse bias. Even though this side there is no polarity, I'm assuming this is the zero. Now, zero and this plus 2 volts, the 2 volts is very high. Now, that's why I am considering from this point, it is initially, it is in reverse bias. Is it clear? Now, for that part, this purpose only, I explained in the previous slide. Now, see, I am not applied any voltage to this circuit. Now, with the help of the DC source, the positive terminal is connected to the N side. That means the 2 volts, it is becoming the plus 2 volts, you are applying at the N side. Other side, it is generally, I am assuming it is a zero, nothing I applied. Now, with respect to this, the plus 2 is high. That's why positive is connected to the negative side. It is in reverse bias. Diode initially will be in reverse bias. Okay, if it is clear, then I can move to the next one. Now, during the positive half of the cycle, if my Vin is less than V, that means my input signal is less than 2 volts, up to the 2 volts, now this side 2 volts is there. Even though you are applying the plus 1.9 volts, still the diode is in reverse bias. Because other side 2 volts is the maximum is there. Now this is making the diode into the reverse bias. Now when the diode will be in forward bias, if this side voltage is greater than this side voltage, then the diode will be in forward bias. Okay, now see here. Now up to the voltage V, up to the 2 volts, now whatever you are applying the input signal, now this input up to the reference voltage V, this is a 2 volts now, I'm assuming up to the 2 volts of your input signal, the diode will be in the reverse bias case because there is a potential difference. This side, the more potential is, the more positive is there compared to this side. Now the more positive is connected to N side, it is in reverse bias. Now up to V, that means up to the plus 2 volts, the diode is in reverse bias. This is an open circuit. Now what is output voltage? This output voltage is nothing but whatever the load is connected across the side, there is no current flowing through this path. Now output is following the input. Now see, this is your V, I am taking up to this portion, output is following your input signal. Is it clear? Because even though you are having a DC source, but there is no current flowing through this path. It is an open circuit. Now this is isolated, this branch is isolated branch you have. Now the complete signal is flowing through the load resistance. Up to what extent? It is less than 2 volts only. Now that's why up to the 2 volts, up to the V volt, up to the reference voltage level, the output is follows the input. Now whenever it V input is greater than V, input voltage is, if it is greater than the 2 volts, what is going to happen? Now if it is greater than 2 volts means, now this side I am assuming this is a plus 2.5, I am taking. Now what is this side? This is a constant plus 2 only because DC source is constant. Now in this case, which one is high? 2.5 volts is higher than the plus 2 volts. Now if you are connecting the more positive to the P side, now what is the type of configuration this is? This is your forward bias configuration. Now see how the diode is switching. Now this diode switching characteristics we can see in the next class. Now up to less than the V volts, less than the reference voltage, it is in reverse bias. Whenever it is greater than the reference voltage, greater than 2 volts, it is acting as your forward bias. Because with respect to this terminal, this is a plus 2 volts is there, here more potential is there. Now plus 3 volts, that means 3 is more greater than the 2 volts. If plus 3 positive is connected to the p-type, that is nothing but your forward bias. Now this is a forward bias case. When it is greater than your V volts, the Vin is two cases. Now Vin is less than reference voltage. Now diode will be in reverse bias and output is following the input. Now when Vin is greater than V, now the diode will be in forward bias. Now tell me, what is output voltage? If it is a forward bias, now there is a short circuit from here to here. If it is a short circuit, what is output voltage? Output voltage will not be zero, because at this point nothing is there, only direct wire is there. A DC source is there in the circuit. Now that's why, what is the reference voltage V you are having, the same thing it is going to be continuous. That means a constant DC source you are going to obtain. Up to what extent it can obtain? Whenever Vin is greater than V, it goes to the maximum value. Till that time, still it is in forward bias. Now he still, even though decreasing case is 4.5 to 4, 3, 3.5, now still up to the 2.1 volt, it is in forward bias. During the forward bias case, now it is going to be short circuited. The output voltage will be the DC voltage, that is a 2 volts only. That's why constant DC 2 volts will be there here. Now whenever the input signal is falling below the reference voltage, the V voltage, whenever V in is less than V, what is going to happen? Once again, it is in reverse bias. This diode is going to be in reverse bias. Whenever it is in reverse bias, it is open circuit, is that there is no current flowing through this branch. Now once again, output is following the input signal. At this point onwards, your output is going to be follows the input signal. Now that's why from at this point, it is following the input, output is following input signal. Now coming to the reverse voltage, when you're applying the negative peak, during the negative peak also, what is going to happen? Always it is going to be in forward bias. Now the negative is connected to the positive here. Now negative peak side, see, this is a negative you are applying, this is a positive, this is a signal you are coming. Now this is a plus 2 volts is there. Now plus negative is connected to the positive side and the positive is connected to the negative side. What is this is configuration you are having? Now this is your reverse bias configuration. Now during the negative peak of the signal, always this diode is in reverse bias. Whenever diode is in reverse bias, there is open circuit at this point. So the complete output is nothing but it is following the input signal. Now that's why output signal will be looks like this. Now what is going to happen? If you introduce a small DC source in the circuit, with respect to this DC source, you can clip only small portion of your positive side. Now if you want to clip only the small portion of your negative side, what you have to do? Now change the orientation of your diode, then it will clip this portion of your circuit. I hope it is clear. Now only the thing you are going to remember, now see the voltages at the two terminals of your diode. Which side is more voltage is there? According to that, the diode is going to conduct. Now initially, up to the, now I am assuming this is 2 volts now. Here 2 volts we are having, this is negative side is plus 2 volts is there. This side is zero only. Now even though still positive peak is increasing, up to 2 volts, up to 1.9 volts, now it is, this side is more dominant to this side. That's why it is in your reverse bias only. Whenever this side is greater than the other side, 2.1 volt is greater than this side, ultimately this diode will turn into forward bias. Whenever it is in forward bias, it is acting as a short circuit. Output voltage is nothing but the DC source voltage. V out is nothing but your V. The same V is going to be continuously, it is going to come. Up to what extent it is going to be there, in, up to V only? Now once again, the signal is falling below the V volts. Now once again, it is below the V volts. Now it is enter the 5 volts peak value. Once again, it is falling the less than 2 volts. Again, it is comes to the reverse bias. Diode turns into reverse bias. Now output is following the input signal. Even though for the negative half of the cycle, diode is always in reverse bias. Now that's why the complete signal is you're going to obtain. Okay, just stick to the basic. Now, during the portion of the signal, what is going to happen? If you are able to analyze, now you can easily predict the output value. Okay, and now finally I'm concluding. If you are introducing a small DC source in the circuit, because of that DC source, a small portion of either positive or negative peak is going to be clipped, not the complete positive, not the complete negative value. Right, now this is the positive peak, clip some portion of your positive peak you are clipping here. Now what is another case? Now I want to clip the negative side. Now what is going to be? Just change the direction of your diode. Now here the reference voltage is a negative value because your negative side is connected battery, negative terminal is connected to the P side. Now change the polarities of your battery and change the direction of your diode, then it is acting as your clipper circuit with the biasing voltage, which is clipping the negative portion of your circuit. Now here you can clearly you can see those who are not getting those are confusing with the previous one. I will explain once again at this point how it is clipping the negative side. Right. Now what is the reference voltage? Here my V is equal to, I am taking the minus 2 volts. Why it is minus 2 volts? Because this is a negative and positive. The DC source is interchanged. Previously this is a positive, this is a negative. See here, this is a positive, this is a negative. That's the plus 2 volts reference voltage in the positive side. Now the battery is changed, now negative to positive. That's why my reference voltage, and not call as reference voltage. Now DC voltage is nothing but it is going to be in the negative side. Now I am assuming my DC voltage is minus 2 volts. Now see, initially what is the status of this diode? Now without applying any signal, negative is connected to the positive side. That means minus 2 volts at this side. At this side 0 volts is there. Now minus, that means negative terminal is connected to the P side. Which type of configuration it is? Reverse bias configuration. Now what is going to happen in the reverse bias? The reverse bias, it is going to be open circuit, diode will open circuit and output will follow the input value. Now up to what extent it is going to be in reverse bias? Input signal is falling below the minus 2 volts. Now where is the minus 2 volts? It will comes in negative peak only. Now see what is going to happen. Now, during the positive half of the signal, initially it is in reverse bias. During the positive peak side, what is going, this is a positive, the plus 1 volt. It's positive to the N side, negative to the P side. This is in reverse bias. This is a normal tendency of your PN junction diode. Now for the plus 5 volts, more and more positive you are applying, it is more and more reverse bias. That's why for the complete positive cycle, the diode will be there in reverse bias only. That's why output is following your input signal. In the reverse bias case, it is going to be open circuit. That's why output voltage is nothing but the input voltage. Now coming to the reverse voltage, negative peak. Now you are applying the negative peak of the input signal. Now what is going to happen initially? Now initially how much voltage you are applying here? Now this is a minus 0.1 volt, or minus 0.5 volts. See, this is a minus, I am assuming this is minus 0.5, this is a minus 1, this is a minus 2. This is the reference voltage. So minus 5 is there, minus 2 is there. Now this side is more negative voltage is there. With respect to this more negative, it is acting as a reverse bias only. Now during the reverse bias, output will follow the input. This output is following the input up to the minus 2 volts. Up to the minus 2 volts. Now whenever the signal goes more than the minus 2 volts, for example, this side is minus 3 volts is there. Now this side minus 2 volts is there. Now with respect to this voltages, this minus 3 negative is connected to the N side. This more negative is connected to the N side. Less negative is connected to the P side. Now you consider only this side portion. More negative is connected to the N side, it is going to be in forward bias. Now during the forward bias, it is going to be short circuited. Now what is output voltage you are going to see? Output voltage is the reference voltage, V out is nothing but your V. That V is minus 2 volts. That means consistently you are going to get the minus 2 volts, minus V. Now once again, up to this portion, it is the minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Minus 5 is more greater than the minus 2. Minus 4 is greater than minus 2, a constant voltage you are going to get. It is in open circuit only, the short circuit only. And now still it is minus 4, it is in short circuit. It is in minus 3, short circuit, coming to the minus 2. Now negative peak came to the minus 2. Whenever it is falling less than the minus 2 volts, that is minus 1.9 is there. Now this will comes into action. Now what is minus 2 is more, negative is connected to the positive side. Now what is the status of this? This is nothing but your reverse bias case. Now in the reverse bias, what is going to happen? This is going to be open circuit. What is the output status? Output will follow the input. Now at this point onwards, whatever input is there, output is following the same input value. That's why now this is the clipper circuit with the biasing voltage. If there is no biasing voltage, there is no DC source, it will clip the complete portion of your negative or it will clip the complete portion of your positive. But if you include the DC source in the circuit, with respect to DC source, only the portion of your either positive or portion of your negative is going to be clipped. Now this is the fourth circuit I explained now. Is it clear? I hope it is clear to everyone. Right. Next one is, no, I want to clip the positive peak and negative peak. Why should I clip only the positive small portion, negative small portion? How to do this? Same thing. Now combine these two circuits, connect these two in parallelly. Now see, now this circuit, this arrangement, and this arrangement, if you connect these two in parallel, now this circuit will remove the positive clip as well as the negative portion of the clip. Just we will see now what is going to happen. Now this V1 is the reference voltage of your first one, first diode D1. V2 is the reference voltage of your the diode D2. Is a negative voltage, is a positive voltage. Now see that during the positive case, now whenever during the positive case, if it is less than, my Vin is less than V1. V1 is this, I am assuming this is the 2 volts. Now, Vin is less than 2 volts, this plus is connected to the negative side. That means the positive is connected to the negative side. Now it is acting as your reverse bias. Reverse bias means it is open circuit. Up to the 2 volts, it is going to be reverse bias. It is open circuit. Now, what is the status of this diode? It is already negative is connected to the positive. This is a minus 2 volts is there. Now, by default, it is in reverse bias. Now, up to this portion, this diode will be in reverse bias. This diode will be in reverse bias. These two will be open circuit. Output is nothing but it is following the input. That means up to this portion, output is follows the input value. Right. Now coming to the second case, whenever Vin is greater than V1, for example, this is a 3 volts, it is greater than this volt, with respect to this, now 3 is more compared to 2. Now this is becoming positive is connected to positive side, negative to negative, that means with respect to this, it is acting as your forward bias. Now this plus 3 volts is there this side, now this is a plus 2 is there, plus 3 is more, now the diode positive is to P side, this is going to be in short circuit, this is in forward bias, now this portion is going to be shorted. But during the for the same plus 3 volts, what is the status of your diode D2? Now more positive is connected to your negative side. Now this is still in reverse bias. Now this is going to be open circuit. Now there is nothing is flowing through this branch. Now whatever is there, what is the output voltage? Now here V1 is, this is a short circuited. Now the current is flowing through this path. Now what is the reference voltage? V1 is there. Now the same reference voltage V1 is appeared across your output side. Because this is in reverse bias, this is open circuit, nothing is there in this branch. Now, still, once again, if it is less than the reference voltage, now what is going to happen? Now it comes to your reverse bias, once again it is in reverse bias, now that's why it is always follows your input signal. Now coming to the negative peak of the signal, for the negative peak of the signal, now directly you can say first one, now what is the negative peak of the signal? This is a negative, this is a minus 1 volt you are applying, this is a plus 2 volts is there, this straight away, this is negative to positive, straight away it is reverse bias. Now leave about the diode D1, and diode D2 is the minus 1 volt is there, I am assuming this is a minus 2 volts is there, this side. Minus 2 is more power compared to minus 1. That means my negative is connected to the positive side, still it is in reverse bias. Now up to this reference voltage V2, up to the V2 it is in reverse bias. Whenever it is in reverse bias, it is going to be open circuited. Output is following your input signal. That's why up to this portion, output will follow. Whenever it is greater than this reference, negative reference level, now this diode will be in forward bias. Now this is a short circuit. This is always in remains in reverse bias. See, during the positive half of the cycle, this diode D2 is always in reverse bias. During the negative half of the cycle, this diode D1 is always in reverse bias. Just you imagine these two. Now what about the D2? See, for the positive half of the cycle input side, this is comes into picture. For the negative half of your input signal, the second portion comes into picture. Now we explained these two separately in the previous one. Just I combined these two so that you are getting this type of signal. I hope this circuit is very clear to everyone. Okay, now what are the different types of clippers we are having? Positive clippers and negative clippers. A clipper which removes the positive portion is nothing but your positive clipper. A clipper which removes the negative portion is nothing but your negative clippers. Once again, the two types of clippers are there, parallel clippers and series clippers. What is a parallel clipper? If output is taking across the diode, that is your parallel clipper circuit. Now, if the output is taking across the load resistance, that is nothing but your series clippers. In the parallel clipper circuits, we discuss the positive clipper circuit and the negative clipper circuit. Okay, and some portion of your positive clipping circuit, small portion of your positive clipping, that means by including the DC source in the circuit, you can eliminate or you can clip the small portion value. And one more thing is small portion of your negative portion, that is including the reverse DC voltage, a DC voltage source in reverse direction, so that you can remove the small portion of your reverse signal. Now by combining these two sources, positive DC source and negative DC source, with the two diodes in the two different directions, so that you can achieve, you can clip the small portion of your positive and the small portion of your negative signal. I hope this is about your parallel clipping circuits. Okay, the parallel clipping circuits are very clear. Output you are collecting across the diode, that is the parallel clipping circuits. Right. Is it clear? The parallel clippers are clear. There are two more slides are there in the today's session. Only the series clippers are there. With the two slides, we can conclude the today's one. Right. Now, series clippers are very, very easy. Already, we are seeing about half-wave rectifier. Now, that is half-wave rectifier is nothing but the example of your series rectifiers. Right, what is a series clipper circuit? If you collect the output across the load, that is nothing but your series clipper circuit. Now, what is going to happen here? Now, generally, if you are assuming, I already told you in the starting of the class, we are assuming it is ideal diode. This blue color line is nothing but your ideal diode. Ideal diode will conduct from Vin is greater than zero. Input signal is greater than zero, the ideal diode will conduct. But when the practical diode will conduct, there is a barrier potential greater than 0.7 only, it is going to conduct. Okay, here in this picture, I shown you differently. Now, what is these two means? Now, this blue color is nothing but for ideal diode. This is for your practical diode. When the practical diode will conduct, when the ideal diode will conduct, that is the same thing. Now, in the series clipper, it is a negative clipper. It is a negative portion, it is clipping. Like it is a simple half-wave rectifier you are having. Now, we'll see the operation. Now, during first, we'll discuss about the ideal case. Ideal case, during the positive case, the positive signal you are applying, this side becoming your positive. Now, positive is connected to the P side. This diode will be in your forward bias. During the forward bias, the complete signal, it will accept the signal. It will accept the positive signal and everything is going to, now you can take the voltage at the load resistance. If you are collecting the output voltage at the load resistance, the complete voltage, that the complete positive peak is, it is passed through the diode. Now that's why the output signal is during the positive half of your signal, output is following the input. Now during the negative case, whenever it is falling below the zero, for below the zero means it is a negative is going to the P side, this diode is in reverse bias, the reverse bias, it is open circuit generally, but there is no current flowing through the load resistance. That's why reverse bias case, there is no current flow. The diode will be in reverse bias, there is no current flow, it is clipping the negative portion. This is about your ideal diode case. Right, now we will discuss about the practical diode. Now what is a practical diode? Our practical diode will conduct whenever input voltage is greater than 0.7 volts. Now, initially take an input signal, it is a zero. I am assuming at this point it is 0.7 volts. Up to this portion, what is the status of this diode? Diode is not in conducting state. Now, if the input is 0.2 volts, this is not enough to conduct the diode. It is still in off only. That's why there is no current flow through the circuit. Now, if it is a 0.5 volts, still it is not greater than barrier potential. Still, there is no current flow. This is off. Still, it is 0.6 volts is there. Even 0.6 is not sufficient to turn on the diode. That's why it is current is zero. Whenever it is 0.7 volts is there, then only diode will conduct. And the diode will conduct, it is in forward bias. Now, it will conduct and its output is following the input signal. Up to what extent it will diode will conduct? Whenever it is reaches to this 0.7 volts, up to that time it will conduct. Whenever input signal is falling below less than 0.7 volts, now for example, at the positive peak, it went to the maximum level of 5 volts, and again it is falling, the 4, 3, 2, 1, and it is 0.7 is there, up to 0.7, the diode will conduct, you are going to see the output signal. It is less than 0.7, 0.6 is there. It is not sufficient to turn on the diode. Once again, the current is equal to 0. Now, in the case less than 0.72, current is 0. Less than 0.7, 0.6, 0.5, 0.4, the current is equal to 0. Now, there is a small difference here. Ideal diode, this is a case. But practically, initial up to 0.7, there is no current flow. And last 0.7, less than 0.7 also, there is no current flow. During the greater than 0.7 and less than 4.3 volts only, the current is flowing through the practical diode. Now, this is the explanation of your series clipper circuit. Here, there is no special explanation here. Just I introduce the concept of your practical diode. Okay, it is practical diode. It will conduct more than 0.7. Whenever it is falling less than 0.7, diode will not conduct. It is in the diode in the reverse bias case. Ultimately, it is not conducting. Zero current is going to flow. Now, if I draw the same thing here, now for ideal diode, negative clip, this is a negative clipper, series negative clipper. Now, this is the ideal diode you are having. For the practical diode, what is the shape of this signal, output signal? Up to 0.7, it is zero. Now, this is a signal, and this is a thing you are getting, and this is the value. Now, my question is, for the practical diode, will you get the same maximum voltage at the output also? No, you will not get it. Because maximum voltage for the practical, that is nothing but Vm minus 0.7. Because already 0.7, that is a 5, if you take the 5 volts as a maximum, the maximum voltage for the practical diode will be 4.3 volts only. Ideal diode, output maximum voltage, input maximum voltage is same. But for practical diode, already 0.7 volts we lost because of the barrier potential. Now it can conduct maximum voltage, it can reach to the maximum. For example, it is a 5 volts is there. Now what is the output side you are getting? You are not getting the 5 volts. 5 minus 0.7, 4.3 only you are getting as a maximum voltage. Now that's why the maximum voltage of your practical diode will be Vm minus 0.7. Now this is a small difference with respect to practical diode, that is for the ideal diode. Just to introduce the concept of practical diode, I kept this slide. Okay, this is a series clipper, series negative clipper. Negative portion is clipping. Now what is the positive clipper? Just you reverse the direction of your diode. Now, if you reverse the direction of the diode, now what is going to happen? Now, during the positive case, positive signal, positive to negative is in reverse bias. During the reverse bias, there is no current flow. Now, up to this portion, it is going to be zero. Now, during the negative cycle, negative half of the cycle, this negative is coming to the negative. That means it is in forward bias. In the forward bias, I'm considering this ideal diode. It is in forward bias, it will conduct the signal, it will conduct the current. Now, whatever the input signal is there, output is following the input signal. Now, this is an ideal diode. Now, can you draw the practical diode here? Practical diode, up to the minus 0.7 volts, it is going to be zero. After minus 0.7 volts, diode will start conducting. Now, once again, up to this minus 4.3 volts, it will conduct. This portion is becoming zero. Now, this is for your practical diode. Okay, now this is a circuit. Just remember the direction when you are drawing in the examinations. Now, in your mind, you imagine if it is a positive side or negative side, P side or N side. Now, which one must be connected to the input signal? Now, to clip a positive portion or to clip a negative portion. Just analyze in your mind and then you, or otherwise you put it on the rough side. In the margin, first you draw the circuit and within 1 minute time, you can analyze which portion it is going to clipping. And draw the final circuit. After checking the circuit, then only you draw the final circuit in the main examination. Okay, blindly, don't by heart these circuit diagrams and don't put all the diagrams in your external examination. Because instead of positive clipping, if you are putting the direction of the diode in reverse direction, that is becoming negative clipping. The concept is going to be different. That's why be careful while drawing the circuit diagrams in the examination. Now with this, and now once again, there is small thing is there here also. Now you can include a biasing voltage here because to clip a some amount of portion, you can include the biasing voltage. Now with this biasing voltage, and you can clip a small amount of the portion. Now you can reduce the clipped value. But take a, for example, this 2 volts is there. Now this 2 volts is minus 2 volts is there here. It is a 2 volts is there. Now if it is more than this only, reference voltage only, now what is the maximum voltage you are getting here? The Vm minus V. Because the two sources will be connected in series. Now, this Vin minus V, that is a reference voltage, Now it is greater than 0.7 volts, then only the diode will conduct. Now this case, this diode is conducting. Now this diode will starts conducting. Just go through this. This is with the biasing voltage. You will get the clarity for the series clipper. That's it. Okay. Now it is almost 1 hour time was completed. Just I am reviewing the today's class. In the today I discuss about the clipper circuit. Now there are two types of clippers are there. Positive clippers and negative clippers. The circuit which is clipping the positive portion, that is a positive clipper. A circuit which is clipping the negative portion, that is your negative clipper circuit. Now there are two types of clippers are there based on the diode position. Now if your output you are collecting across the load, that is a series clipper circuit. Now if your output is collecting across your diode, that is a parallel clipper circuit. In the parallel clipper circuits, now we discuss the five different circuits. First one is a parallel positive clipper circuit, a parallel negative clipper circuit, and the parallel portion of your positive clipper circuit, and the parallel portion of your negative clipper circuit, and the fifth one is the portion of positive and the portion of negative clipper circuits. These are the five circuits we discussed. Next, coming to the series clipper circuits, now we discuss the series positive clipper and the series negative clipper, and as well as the series clipper with the biasing voltage. Just to go through this last slide, you will get the clarity with all the concept what you having from the previous 10 slides. Now if you apply the input voltage, if it is greater than the battery voltage, now which voltage is going to apply to the diode, according to that, what is the status of this diode? Now if you are observing in this slide, so that you can get the full clarity about this picture. Okay, with this I am closing the clippers concept today. And with this our clippers concept was completed. And now we move on to the today's quiz part. Today quiz is on completely clippers. Now if you listen the clippers concept neatly, then you can attempt the quiz within 5 minutes of time. Once again, I will flash the slides before going to the quiz. Now just see the slides. First thing is the clippers. Other name of clippers is limiters, amplitude selectors, or slicers. What is the purpose of clippers? It is used to eliminate the portion of the signal. What is a positive clipper and what is a negative clipper? I explained. What are the different types of clippers, series and parallel clippers? And what is going to happen if you are introducing a DC source in the circuit, if there is no DC source in the circuit? I hope the MCQs mostly will be there on this concept only. And now we'll start the quiz now. Madam, will you run the quiz now? Yeah, quiz started already. All of you take the quiz. Mostly it will take maximum 5 minutes of time only, those who listen my class.